Oui, c'est ça.
Yesin.
Generally, yes, now for night, it's simply yours. When you go back there, the people like what you saw the woman the other day wearing it. So for them, the best gift you can take for them this. And the kaftan is when they are invited to the wedding in the city. Whereas this one is when they are still in the countryside.
Thank you.
Stella, let's go fish.
A Catholic Church of Our Lady of Lourdes, which is for another faith, but what is also one of the most beautiful building inheritance, architectural inheritance, with all these beautiful stained glasses. So the cubic shape of the buildings, they are all like what you see here on your left hand side, where you see ORMA. It is one typical Art Deco building, and you have the yellow one also over there, and you have the one in the corner also. Here we call it Twin Center. Twin Center, and you have two big towers, one is a hotel and the other one is a business center. And you see all these buildings now are representing the Art Deco. You are going to Mohammed the Fifth Square. Start the one of the city halls of Casablanca on your left hand side. And this one is the siege of the province of Casablanca. And just next to it on your right hand side, you can see the French flag over there, owned by the French consulate. And then you have the courtyard here. We do a small stop here if you want to go down and take photos. Casablanca is the best place to drive in. Tomorrow morning, it will not be the same tank. Just today at the end of the afternoon, it will not be the same tank. Rush hour at this time of the day, you cannot pass this street light in 1 minute or two. You need minimum 15 minutes to move from one street light to another one. So here we are in Hassan II Avenue. And you have one of the public transportations that is crossing, the city. There is one line. The Arab League Park. They just restored it, and it is still under restoration. What was missing before was the parking for the vehicles, so they put a parking here. And then they are still restoring all the different parts of the Arab League. When French occupied Morocco, the capital was Fes. Was Fes, yes. Was Fes, and then the French tried to first to make of Casablanca their capital, and after then they changed mind and they moved the capital to Rabat. and there was at that time the French government in exile, I mean Vichy. So our hotel is here, our hotel is here on your left hand side, Kenzie Tower. It is our hotel. And just like I would like to do the check-in now, but the rooms are not done yet. I want to, I called already because the people they just left at midday. So, and I said that there was the French government on exile, which was Vichy, pro-Nazi. And then there was the French government pro-Nazi of Vichy, whereas there was the opposition to Vichy that created their government in exile, and the leader was De Gaulle, in Algeria. And probably, why didn't the American and the British talk about this meeting to France? They were afraid of the spies pro-Vichy to spread out the news, and so that the meeting cannot be held peacefully. And also the choice of Casablanca, it was not done in a very hazardous way. It was done as a diversion because the British and the Americans know previously that the German Gestapo is going to think about the American White House. I mean that if we give them permission and they didn't speak up about this meeting, they will help him to get the independence of the country by forcing France to give the independence. And of course De Gaulle, he learned about the meeting. He wasn't happy after the Americans and the British, but instead he came and he considered that what they did has been that they are interfering in the internal matters of France. The people are not working. The majority of the shops, the business are closed. Rock and Dixon, you spend a lot of time. And here we are on the Enfer Avenue. Yeah. Official, the meeting, I mean some of the secret meetings was held in this small building. Where was the hotel where they stayed? It is in front of you to the left. It is still used as unofficial, I mean it is official hotel, hosting, I mean important personality. There is this one, it is kind of private, and there is the yellow building here, on your left hand side. Well, the white one, yes, for security, and because there are two like private villas, and the guests are, everyone is taking one of these residences. And sometimes even now, if there is any chief of state that is visiting in Casablanca, he's staying in one of these residences, beautiful palaces inside. Rounding the Saudi King's Palace. Above, there is a Saudi King Palace. It is just at the entrance of La Corniche.
It doesn't come anymore, huh? Roosevelt, Coffee Roosevelt, huh? So we are entering to the... I'll go to the Corniche.
But your choices, do you still remember or not? I have a list, huh? And I hope that it will not rain. And this way, after you finish lunch, you can go for a small walk along the Corniche. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in here, have the sea view, and the restaurants that I'm going to show you, they have also indoor space, so although the majority of them have terraces. Okay. The Moroccan, it is also a space to which the Moroccans are coming mainly during Sunday during the weekend, but the majority of the market, they just eat their breakfast now, just woke up. Some are coming for also this. So you have one restaurant here, it is called Assad, to the left hand side, and it is serving kind of Moroccan food, or let's say, Assad, kind of Moroccan food, grilled meat or things. You have also where you see the Miami beach, Miami plage, on the other side, there's a good restaurant serving seafood. You can have pizzas, you can have them, and there is no reason to charge for you for bread or for olives. This it is automatically included. To give you the price, it is 130, so I'll show you the cashier where you are going to pay. For this, if it is crowded, you can give me and they give the ticket for the whole group. So in this way, you don't have to queue behind the others. We'll see if there is many people. Not doing it this way, they are accepting. If you don't have, for example, Moroccan cash, you accept Moroccan cash for the payment of the entrance, or you can use the credit card. Also the credit card, you can use it if you want to visit. And how it is working, because you are visiting where the people are praying. You visit where the people are praying. So at the entrance, they give you bags. Bags where you are going to put your shoes. And you take your shoes with you till you finish the visit. And then when you finish the visit of the place where the people are praying, of course you put on your shoes again and you walk normally. And when you take off your shoes, you are stepping and you are working on the rugs that are used for praying.
They close at 3 o'clock.
Have you ever been inside a bar before, so you have to show me
around? About the bar? Well, you should come. You should come 25 years ago. Huh? I know all the bars, the address of the bars of Casablanca, of Morocco. after 25 years. Now if somebody is asking me where can I buy wine, I have to think about it 3 hours. It's been fun drinking wine, and I don't want him to share wine with me in paradise. 20 years till 40, we are having fun. We live our life. No thanks is forbidden. 40, we start remembering that, okay, it is too much.
We reduce the quantity.
And 50 years old, we start our confession. At 60, we go to pilgrimage. Once we go to pilgrimage, we forget about all this. And what is also extraordinary is sometimes you have a person.
So here, ladies and gentlemen, you see the label of McDonald's there. You see it? By the way, in front of you. By the way, it was the first McDonald's that was open on the African continent and in an Arab country. This one. A historical monument. McDonald's on your left-hand side. It was opened in 1992. The first one. First McDonald's in Morocco, in an Arab country, in the African continent. This one. So they are charging for the visit now, huh? I'm joking. So what is interesting is the Moroccan, when they are planning the opening of this McDonald's, the Moroccan newspapers was talking about it. And there is one journalist that reported the news with a big title. What is eaten by the poor Americans will be eaten by the rich Moroccans. Now why? Because where it is open, if you don't have a car and if you are not rich, you can never reach it. So, and nowadays, McDonald's in Casablanca, they have more than 10 restaurants just in Casablanca. And in all big cities, they have one or two restaurants, and they start even now building them on the toll road. You see, on the toll road the other day, going from Rabat to Fes, and I saw this morning one restaurant, they make of it McDonald's between Marrakech and Agadir and Casablanca. So here you can see the mosque. What makes the specificity of this mosque, it is built on the water. Country and the capacity, the inside capacity of the mosque, it can host till 35,000 people. And with the square outside, still 100,000 people. And the whole building, it is made of marble, green marble as we call it, and they have also the green tile that are decorating. And the tower is about 236 meters high, so about 690 feet or 700 feet high. And it have also, because sometimes maybe this evening when you go on the rooftop at the time of prayer, they turn on a laser light on the top, a green, that you can see it is going till the horizon west and till the horizon east. So, and you see this, and it has also, you see the green roof, the green, and there is a small green roof on the top. It is a retractable roof. It opens. It opens within 5 minutes. They don't open it all the time for the simple reason that once at any moment they open it, you have all the pigeons that are getting in. So when they start building their nests inside, and it spoils the decorations inside. Beautiful, as I told you. And all this, also this garden, this promenade, is part of the project of the mosque. So they make it beautiful, and it is beautiful than what it used to be before the construction of the mosque. Because where the mosque is built used to be the Olympic swimming pool. The adults, the kids. For example, I have my kid who is 9 years old when he has a piece of... So here, ladies and gentlemen, for this mosque, it was the project of the King Hassan II. It was he that decided about its construction and also the money. It is he that provided the money, but there was also the donations that was given by the Moroccan population at that time, and that they wanted to contribute, to donate also. But the donation, it was subject of a big controversy when they started, because the people I mean, they wanted to donate what they wanted, and suddenly they found themselves obliged to give certain amounts. So, and it is for this reason the people started criticizing. We'll stop in front of the Rick's Cafe first, and then we come back here. It will allow to the bus also to turn. And then for those that will visit the inside and show you where you get your ticket, and those that are not interested, they'll tell you at what time we'll come back, and then we'll go to the hotel to do the check-in. And those that are visiting the inside, you wait for me till I come back. 2019. And where you see the big building is the new marina, is the marina of Casablanca. It is still new and they are still building it, and they planned also big mall there, Marina Mall. Creation or the foundation of this Rick's Cafe in 2004. So 2004, she looked for a house in the movie. So from the windows, they can see the harbor, they can see the ship coming and going up. So the Rick's Cafe is here. Inside, but nobody is playing. It works mainly as a restaurant, very busy restaurant.